Warning, hydrogen peroxide and sodium hydroxide are corrosive. Wear gloves when handling them. Greetings, fellow nerds. In this video, we're going to make a chemiluminescent reaction that oscillates on and off. First, we get about 100 milliliters or so of distilled water and add to it 37 milligrams of copper sulfate pentahydrate. This needs to be dissolved separately first because I find if mixed directly with the rest of the chemicals, it tends to clump due to precipitation. While that's dissolving, in a separate larger container, we start with 3.6 grams of potassium thiocyanate. To this, we add 1 gram of sodium hydroxide and 0.2 grams of luminol. Now we add about 200 milliliters of water and stir until everything is dissolved. We're going to add more water later, but using a lesser amount now helps to dissolve the luminol better thanks to the high pH of the sodium hydroxide. Anyway, after everything is dissolved, we now add more water along with the copper sulfate solution we had earlier. Then we top up with enough water to about 1 liter of total volume. Now I'm going to put in a digital thermometer and heat up my reaction to about 50 degrees Celsius. This is entirely optional and you can run it at room temperature. But heating makes the pulses faster and brighter. Okay, we're at the right temperature. Now we add in 30 milliliters of 3% hydrogen peroxide. You can also use 300 milliliters of 3% hydrogen peroxide, but you'll have to use less water in the original mixture. Anyway, now we turn off the lights and wait. At first there will be a weak glow coming from the solution, but after some time it will suddenly brighten with a pulse of light. And there we go. What's happening is that there are multiple competing reactions that oscillate between light and dark for dominance. The exact mechanism is quite complex, so I won't cover it here. But if you'd like to read upon further, you can check the links in the video description. Now while the pulses are real time, I'm actually speeding up the induction period in between them. It usually takes about 30 seconds between each pulse. Eventually, the chemicals will run out and the reaction will stop and go dark. Anyway, so that was an oscillating luminol reaction or a pulsing glow stick. Thanks for watching. Special thank you to all of my supporters on Patreon for making these science videos possible with their donations and their direction. If you're not currently a patron but would like to support the continued production of science videos like this one, then check out my Patreon page here or in the video description. I really appreciate any and all support.